이번엔 뉴스타파가 마련한 특별기획, 세상을 바꾸는 힘 비영리 탐사 매체 세 번째 순서입니다. 미국 정계의 거대 언론 매체 못지않은 영향력을 발휘하고 있는 탐사보도 전문기관 CPI, 즉 미국 공공청렴센터를 소개합니다. CPI는 최근 조세 피난처 프로젝트로 세계적인 명성을 떨친 ICIJ의 모 기관이기도 합니다. CPI의 대표 빌 부젠버그를 뉴스타파 대표 김용진 기자가 만났습니다.
미국 방송 탐사보도 프로그램의 대명사 60미닛. 당대 최고의 프로그램이었지만 프로듀스 찰스 루이스는 이곳을 박차고 나왔습니다. 주류 매체의 한계를 느꼈기 때문입니다. 그는 자유롭게 탐사보도를 할 수 있는 독립 언론을 원했습니다. 그때가 1989년. 비영리 탐사보도 매체 CPI는 그렇게 시작됐습니다.
He had a couple of stories that were stopped as a 60 Minutes producer. He didn't like that. So he quit and he said, I'm going to start my own center and no one will be able to tell us what to do or what not to do. So he started the center at his home in 1989 and began doing reporting and did some of the very first reports about the revolving door between government, trade officials, and then private people in the trade industries.
그로부터 25년, CPI의 탐사보도는 이제 미국뿐 아니라 전 세계를 뒤흔들고 있습니다. 산하기관인 ICIJ의 조세 피난처 보도가 대표적입니다.
It's the biggest project that the center or ICIJ has ever done. I think we can say there have been now 25,000 different media citations of this work worldwide.
워싱턴 백악관 근처의 한 고풍스러운 건물에 있는 CPI 사무실. 매일 아침 각 분야 에디터들이 모인 가운데 편집회의가 열립니다. 설립자 루이스에 이어 지난 2007년부터 CPI를 이끌고 있는 빌 부젠버그는 공영 라디오 NPR의 뉴스 부문 부사장 출신입니다.
The head of its news TAPA, which is an investigative news site, video site in Korea. They were our partner on the ICIJ project.
이날 회의에선 정치 자금 문제가 주로 거론됐습니다. 사회적으로 의미 있고 중요한 사안만 다룬다는 CPI의 방침을 엿볼 수 있습니다. 부젠버그 대표에게 소규모 독립 언론인 CPI가 세계 굴지의 언론사 못지않은 영향력을 지닐 수 있게 된 배경이 뭔지 물었습니다.
Because the center could spend months and months and months working and began filing freedom of information requests and develop going very deep into a subject, it could provide work that nobody else was doing. And even in the beginning, others in the media would recognize they didn't spend as much time, they couldn't do all that work, they couldn't do the detailed work.
And reported on it, and of course that was the former company of the vice president at the time, Dick Cheney. It was his company that he was CEO of. So that was a very big report. It won a number of awards. Another was the, it's called the Fat Cat Hotel. It was the fact that in the Clinton administration, a person could give a donation, usually about $100,000 or more, to the Clinton administration and then they could spend a night in the White House in the Lincoln bedroom. So it was a very good report and a very famous one.
이처럼 CPI는 정치와 돈의 함수 관계를 집중 추적해 왔습니다. 안보와 환경 문제도 주요 취재 분야입니다.
We have about six areas. The main work that we do otherwise is the money in politics. That's we call it consider the source. It tracks money in politics and campaigns and elections. We have a national security project. We're working in national security, a lot of defense spending and overspending in that area.
We have the expertise. We've hired people who can work in these areas. For example, the national security area. I have a Washington Post reporter. He was a Pulitzer Prize winning reporter. Came to us, wanted to do national security. So we knew this was an area we wanted to do.
각 분야의 전문 기자들이 포진해 있는 CPI. 이들의 탐사 보도는 방대한 데이터와 비밀 문서에 기반하는 치밀함과 정부를 상대로 소송도 불사하는 공격적인 취재로 정평이 나 있습니다.
Probably the biggest area, we love data and documents. And we have many whistleblowers giving us documents. We have many leaked documents. We file freedom of information requests all the time. I have a lawyer on the staff who files, we call it a FOIA, a freedom of information request to the government. The government often says no, so we sue the government, and then the government says, okay, let's figure out a way, and we usually get what we want. We have something called computer-assisted reporting. These are people who work with big sets of data, and they will work with a reporter and will come up with key information, and then the report will be based on that. So that's often how we work. We're not, the story ideas come from everywhere. Sometimes we see something no one is doing. I can give you examples from when the financial crisis hit, everyone is writing about the financial crisis, and we said, well, we need to write who caused this. So we went and got a freedom of information request for all the mortgages. We started with 350 million mortgages, and we pulled out the top 25 subprime lenders, who they were, how they operated, what their interest rates were, what their political contributions were, who backed them, and then we did reporting on the people who we believe caused the financial crisis. And again, that was a story. Nobody else was doing that story.
실제 CPI엔 이런 취재를 가능케 하는 미국 최고 수준의 데이터 분석 전문가들이 일하고 있습니다.
A lot of the good evidence, a lot of the good stuff you really wanted to find to support your investigation were in public documents, federal government documents. Well, like everybody, the federal government and other governments went from paper documents to electronic databases and documents. So you need those CAR skills if you're going to pull the good evidence out for your investigation.
컴퓨터 활용 보도와 발로 뛰는 전통적 탐사 취재가 결합할 때 완성도 높은 기사가 나올 수 있다고 강조합니다.
Almost all stories at the center are team-based, where we bring teams of reporters together. So you have reporters that have data skills and also reporters who have great interviewing skills and great other investigative skills, and they work together as a team. In data journalism, rarely, if ever, is a story based only on the data work. Often, though, the tip, the idea for the story, the actual evidence might be in the data, but then I like to say the reporting just begins. Because the data often can tell you how things happened, they can tell you where, when, and what's happening, but data is not very good at why. Why did this happen? And that's where a lot of the traditional investigative skills really come in and are necessary. So when my data work is done and I'm turning over the data results often to an investigative reporter, that's when the fun just begins.
CPI의 가장 큰 특징 중 하나는 전 세계의 탐사 전문 기자들을 규합해 국제적인 탐사 보도 조직을 운영한다는 것입니다. 바로 조세 피난체 프로젝트로 잘 알려진 ICIJ, 즉 국제 탐사 보도 언론인 협회입니다.
This was about 15 years ago. Chuck Lewis was the director of the center, and he wanted to figure out a way to work internationally. So it was a good idea. It began. Chuck hired a director, and ICIJ started doing international work, just as the center did domestic work. And it has grown and grown. And I think right now we're up to almost 200 different members around the world. So it's a very good idea that was started a long time ago. And I think the proof of it is, in a way, the work that you have done in Korea. offshore leaks project. He's done a fantastic job. So it's a project that I'm very proud of. And it clearly has had a big impact in Korea. I give you credit, great credit, for taking the information that we shared and then making it into stories because you understood the names and the importance and you were able to craft a story and then make it stick. In other words, I think the government and people have paid attention to that work because of its quality and its depth, and I salute you for it. I very much believe that it's sustainable, and we have existed for 25 years. It hasn't been easy. I don't think it's ever going to be just, you know, completely, it will be challenging to keep it. But I can expect another 25 years for the Center for Public Integrity to do this work and to have an even bigger impact than we've had. So yes, I'm very, very bullish on the sense of the future of this kind of work and this particular center. I believe in it very, very much. It's the most important journalistic work I've done, and I really believe in the work that we do. And thank you for saying that you felt like it's a model for some of the things you do. I consider that an honor because you have your own model in Korea that you have developed that I think we all admire in this country. The center is very much a nonpartisan center. Who's ever in the White House, they don't necessarily like us. And we've reported on the Obama administration, the numbers of bundlers. These are big funders who have gone to the White House. We've gone through the list of everybody visiting the White House to show that here are the people who get contracts from the White House, here are the bundlers. So whichever the Bush administration, the Obama administration, the Clinton administration, they don't necessarily like us.
한 승부적 탐사 저널리스트의 집에서 시작해 지난 25년 동안 탐사 보도의 외길을 달려온 CPI. 이들이 오로지 탐사 보도에 전념해온 이유는 무엇일까?
I think we know inherently as journalists that finding out information, playing a watchdog role in a democracy, you know, investigative journalism isn't just to report and have people read it, it's really to have an impact. To hold people accountable, and I feel like this is the importance of what we do. There's reporting on events, and there's, you know, features, and there's all kinds of things that could be done, but this kind of journalism is harder, it's riskier, it's more costly, it takes longer, but I think it's more important to the democracy that there are watchdogs looking and reporting than anything else.